Hi, good morning. This is Dr. Priyadarshini. Today, we are going to see the analysis of novella called Vaadivasan, which is originally written in Tamil by C.S. Chellappa in 1940s. It was translated into English by N. Kalyana Raman in 2013. It was translated by him. This particular story, Vaadivasan, is about a bull and the one who captures it. Let us go into the story. I welcome you all. Hi friends, today we are going to see the analysis of the novella Vaadivasan, which is written by C.S. Chellappa in 1940s. Chinnamanoor Subramanian Chellappa, that was his full name, was a journalist and an Indian independent movement activist. He belonged to a literary movement along with Pudhumai Pitta. Now let us see about this particular novel, Vaadivasan, which is a novella. As I told, it has been written in 1940s in Tamil. It was translated by N. Kalyana Raman in 2013. This particular novella, which is translated into English, was published by Oxford University Press in the year 2013. In one line, if we say the story, we can say Vaadivasan is a story about a bull and the one who captures it. The characters in this novella are, the main role is played by Pichi, who is a hero of the story, who is a bull tamer, and his friend Marudan, who is his brother-in-law too. And Ambuli Thevan is Pichi's father, and Mukkaya Thevar, who is a Periyapatti Zameen, and an old man is also in the story, who is referred as Pattaya. In Tamil, it is referred as Kizhavanar, and here the author has translated is as Pattaya in the story, an old man who gives information. And also the important role is also played by Kari, which is the bull. Here the author does not have any heroine, but the place of heroine is taken in the form of Kari. The equal importance to Pichi is given to the character Kari in this novella. Let us go into the story of Vaadivasan. In the beginning of the story, we are introduced to a Chellai festival, which is going to take place in Periyapatti. Now every year during this Chellai festival, the bull taming contest will take place, which is very famous, and people from in and around the village will eagerly come every year to watch this bull taming festival. And especially the important reason for many people coming to this particular bull taming festival is Kari, the untamed bull till date. Now, the day of this festival, Chellai festival, people are gathered there. Early morning, people come to this particular place to find a place for them, and they want to witness this particular scene from a very close, as closely as possible. So they come very early. For this particular festival, Pichi and Marudan also come very early in the morning, and they never expose or they never inform to anybody that they have come there to participate in that particular festival, a bull taming game contest. And Pichi and Marudan sits next to this Pattaya, an old man who gives many information about this festival and also about the bull taming contest, and he gives little tips about how the bull should be tamed. Pichi just take the information, and whenever this Pattaya asks for beetle leaves, he gives it to them, and slowly he gets that information from that old man. And the old man also recollects a past when Kari had almost a man left him dead by hitting him, or as he has come to tame him. And Pichi knows the man that the old man is referring to is none other than his father, Ambali Thevan. So here we are going to see the flashback of Pichi, which is very shortly given in this particular story. Ambali Thevan, who was Pichi's father, who was attacked by Kari and he was badly injured. Lifelong he was bedridden. As a small boy, Pichi has witnessed the pain and suffering that his father has undergone. So his father was a very popular or a very well-known bull tamer. He comes and takes part in this Chelai festival few years back, and when he tries to tame Kari, he gets injured, and because of that he has become bedridden and he has suffered a lot. Now Pichi has come to the same Chelai festival to take revenge upon Kari, who has made his father bedridden. And also when he is dead, his father's last wish was to defeat that particular Kari, was his last wish. So as a son, he has come there to fulfill his father's wishes. And now we know the flashback of Pichi's father, who was a bull tamer, was felled by Mukkaya Teva's Kari and has become paralyzed. So Pichi has come with the motto of defeating Kari in this bull taming contest. Now let us go into the festival. As the time have gone by, the people have rushed in and the whole place is filled with people. They are cheering up each and every young man who has a interest in bull taming. They come forward and they partake in the contest. Pichi and Marudan is also patiently waiting. They never aim for any other bull because they have come with the motto of defeating Kari. That is their main and their prime interest. They are waiting for the Kari to come. The Kari's introduction, which is given by the author, is fabulous. In this particular story, there is no heroine, but Kari has taken that place. The author has given a very detailed information about the bull in this particular story, the Kari, about its physique, about its horn, about the color of its skin, and how ferocious it looks. Almost we feel, you know, that much in interested to even read it again and again. The author has shown almost we can say the author has painted by words the way the Kari is introduced here. And as soon as the Kari enters from the Wadi Vasal, Marudan and Pichi enter the place. So I would like to read few lines from the book when Kari is introduced. Look how it's standing there like a falcon. If this bull runs away too, like all other donkeys, then what? If there is ever a bull that will stand its ground and gore the tamer, it's this one. And the Easterner is going to hold this one, is he? People are mocking at Pitchy the way, you know, when he is trying to tame Kari. Now, the Kari standing there was like a challenge to everyone present to lay a hand on it. Because the Jameen, till then nobody has tamed that Kari. It is almost the pride of Mukkaya Teva. You know, he has given in its bull's horns, he has tagged a gold chain and also so many gold coins in it. And whomsoever tames that particular bull will take all the treasure which the bull has. So almost it is like a great pride when some, till then nobody has tamed it. If at all Pitchy has done, is going to do that, he's going to be a hero in a day. And especially he's going to be celebrated and he's going to be spoken about throughout that place. And for the months to come, he is going to people are going to talk about him. And when the Kari enters there and Pitchy and Marudan stand there, and almost Pitchy and Marudan stood motionless before the bull and in front of its horns. Now the bull is looking at them directly in front of these two men, and Murugan just move away a little backwards because they doesn't know that whom it is going to pounds on, and they are trying to distract the Kari's attention, and almost it is looking at Pitchy and Marudan, and Kari did not move. And it is also the Kari is not like other bulls. It has been very strong, and it is almost, what do you call, they call it an intelligent bull. Now Kari is attacked by Pitchy, and almost the fierce Kari doesn't give up so easily. Almost Kari is standing at the spot, which is kept thumping the ground with its hooves, and it is sorting and waving its horns. Now Pitchy stood directly in front of its arm. Now Marudan is gone back towards place where the Kari's tail is, and both of them is looking at the eyes of each other and expecting a sign. As soon as Pitchy gives a glance above the bull's head, which is giving the information to Marudan, and he gives a sound like drrr. Now Marudan's voice resounded, piercing through the murmurs around Wadi Vasil. Now the bull slightly turns up. Now Pitchy takes this opportunity to got hold of the bull. But the bull cannot be tamed so easily. When he hugged close to its chest and he glued to its body, to its neck, and he laid the hand on its right horn, almost a slapping sound was heard by the crowd. So it is like a lightning flash Pitchy did it, and the Kari is trying to show its power. Almost it is leaping like a snake head. It is liking to throw him off. And this was the first time that people of that region had the opportunity to witness the Kari's traits firsthand. The way it behaved with intelligence equal to that of a human was truly awesome. People commented, "Is it really an animal? It is showing as much cunning as a human." Now, Marudan, and Pichi is trying their best to tame the bull, and Marudan is helping Pichi with his eye contact and so on, and Pichi has a very strong hold on Kari and he is trying to press it down. His right horn was being pushed in that opposite direction and people come and Ada, it's leaping like a snake head. It's trying to throw him off back. When he is wheeled around and thrown, he'll be so good as dead. It is good to be thrown him down and skin him alive. Now, Pichi is not leaving the hold on Kari. Marudan is yelling at him, don't let it go. Don't let it go of your hold. Pichi hands were shaking. He's almost losing. His hands are losing from the bull. His body swung in the air. Almost it has been making him round and round. And Marudan is screaming, don't let go, don't let go. There was a panic in the crowd. And this time, once again, Pichi has survived one jump. And almost it has rolled him up. And not only once, nearly twice or thrice it has jumped. And at last in the end, people are saying, oh, Vadipuram bull is going to be tamed at last. And nearly, I'm going to read few lines from the novella, how Kari is introduced. The Kari stood majestically at the wicket gate. The animal battened, glistening black hump jutted impressively above the neck high wooden enclosure, springing fork-like from its edges of the mound on its forehead. Its two sharply pointed horns with a small hook-like curve at each tip glittered and shone impressively. With its head lowered and eyes downcast, it steps forward confidently and slowly, hums subtly, and hot swaying from side to side. It came halfway out. So we can see the novel beautifully captures the cultural significance of Jallikattu, the life of rural Tamil Nadu. It is not only explaining a festival, a Chalai festival, or not just a bull taming contest. It is interwoven with feudalism, caste hierarchies, masculinity and patriarchy here. Especially when we see the zamindas, that is the Periyapatti zamin's pride is hurt. The Kari is looked as a pride of Periyapatti zamin Mukkaya Thevar. It's a beautiful novella and wonderfully translated in English, and almost just within 150 pages, and I enjoyed thoroughly reading this particular work. If you find time and you want to know about Chalai, what is Chalai festival, and about a person called Pichi, please read the novel, and definitely ask me. You too will enjoy reading this wonderful novella. Thank you for listening. This is Dr. Priyadarshini signing off. Until to meet you with another interesting story. Thank you. Have a good day.